Fluoride toxicity causes the bone to dissolve. It actually causes the teeth to dissolve, believe it or not.
But isn't fluoride supposed to be good for our teeth?
That's what they tell us. I don't believe them, but that's what they tell us. Right. If you get enough fluoride into your teeth will rot and fall out.
Wow.
That's one of the toxic reactions to fluoride. That's one of the signs of fluoride toxicity, actually.
Okay.
It's rotten
your
teeth.
Your teeth fall out.
Right.
Okay.
It does the same thing with your bones. It rots your bones. It causes the bones to become soft and brittle.
Is that why I read a study within the last couple of years that fluoride has been linked to osteosarcoma? Is that why?
Yes, absolutely.
Bone cancer.
Absolutely. Bone cancer.
Okay.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It weakens the bone. You know, it weakens the teeth, weakens the jaw, weakens the bones. It, you know, long bones, femurs, you know.
Right.
Look at all the hip replacements that have to happen, you know. We have, weakened bones, okay? And, you know, bones weaken as we get, bones become harder and less flexible as we get older.
Okay.
They shouldn't get more brittle. Okay, if we have a decent diet, we're getting plenty of minerals, and we mineralize our bones, they should become stiffer, not more brittle.
But almost inevitably, in most elderly, they're brittle. I remember my grandma before she died.
Sure.
I think she broke her hip.
Couldn't even give her a hug.
She broke her hip one time just walking.
Sure, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Terribly brittle bones. We've been fluorinated in the United States for about 70 years, heavily fluorinated, and osteoporosis is rampant. Mm-hmm. It's rampant in men, elderly men. You know, and testosterone, which is our, boy hormone, should keep our bones strong, you know? And despite that, the fluoride's still eating away at our bones.
So you think that's one of the major problems with the osteoporosis?
Absolutely.
The fluoride.
Absolutely.
Okay.